Hi, I'm Susan Longley. I'm from Atlanta, Georgia, and you're watching GoTerran TV.
Baby, I'm ready to go. Hey, everybody. Happy Monday, November the 23rd. Welcome to GoTerran TV. Side by side, we're welcoming for the first time ever Susan Longley from Atlanta, Georgia. Susan, how are you doing today?
I'm doing great, Taryn. Thanks. Thanks for having me on.
Thanks for joining us. It's wonderful to have you here. And just wanted to say to everybody out there, Susan is a fitness professional, personal trainer, water aerobics instructor. She's available at Family Life Center. We're going to get into that and talk about that. But Susan, first and foremost, again, thank you for your time coming on here. Can you tell the folks out there a little bit about yourself and how you ended up in Atlanta and how you ended up in health and fitness?
Oh, okay. Okay. Well, I ended up in Atlanta by being born here, which is pretty unusual.
It is. Yes, that's true.
And I've been here all my life, except for 2 years that I went to Florida State University. So, I've been active and been fit most of my life. It's always been something that was important to me. I did run the New York City Marathon.
Oh, wow.
In 1997. Ooh. That was probably
nice.
my biggest thing. Right,
awesome.
So I had a good chance. Wow. That's the only marathon. I did the Atlanta Half Marathon a couple of times, but that was the only full marathon I did. And I just didn't want to do one that wasn't fun. I wanted to do San Francisco or New York or something where I really got a chance to see some sights while I was there. And I did. So that was great. And I've been a teacher and a coach. I'm also a certified personal coach. So I've got a lot of experience working with people on meeting goals and getting what they want. So I'm new to actually training in fitness. I've really enjoyed what it has given me. And I'll tell you a little story. About several years ago, I broke my arm.
Oh, wow.
And I had been, so I was in a cast. I was, you know, my arm was up here. It was always in a cast. It was a sling, but I couldn't move my arm basically for 8 weeks. And it was over Christmas holidays, so there was a lot to eat around. And I couldn't get out and do anything, so I didn't do anything. I gained a lot of weight. And I decided that I wanted to, that after I finished therapy, I was going to go back to the gym. Because I'm 66 years old, I was 64 at the time, and I just noticed that I was really slowing down and that I was losing balance, I was losing muscle strength, and I really didn't like that because I don't expect to be gone anytime soon, so it was like, I don't think I want to do it this way. So I did start working out, and as soon as I got finished with therapy, and it just felt so good to be back at the gym, and I started with water aerobics, and then started working with a trainer, and then decided that I wanted to do that for other people my age, because it has made so much difference to me in what I'm looking forward to for the rest of my life, rather than what I know could have been my story if I hadn't gotten myself to that gym.
That's tremendous. That's great.
So I'm eager to share.
Yeah, that's wonderful. What a testimonial. How did you end up breaking your arm, by the way?
I just tripped and fell. Not over anything in particular, just something that was laying around in the floor. And I don't think I would trip over it now. If I tripped over it now, I would have the strength and balance to just plant my leg and not go down.
Sure.
I know that if the same thing happened to me now, I wouldn't fall.
Absolutely.
So it feels much better.
That's great. It's a good thing kind of how that happened, because that sounds like brought you to a path of where you're at now and being involved in
Well, the other thing that happened is right before that happened, my kid sister told me that I walk like an old lady.
Oh, wow.
And that hurt. And then after I broke my arm, I realized that I really was walking like an old lady. So, okay, so this isn't going to happen anymore. And so I'm loving being in the gym now. It's really great.
Good for you.
And I've got clients that are that I've got several clients that have never exercised in their life before. And they're like just beginning to realize what it can be. And they're in their 60s. And although my oldest client is 92,
Oh my God,
and
that's
she
amazing.
can still tap dance.
Oh wow.
I love, but she's making steady. She's progressing. She's gone from 2 pounds to 3 pounds, and she even picked up her daughter's 4 pound weights one time and started doing some front raises. And I said, "Well, let's go back to the 3 pounds just for right now." But she'll be
Yeah.
there. She'll be there.
Oh,
I love to.
that's
I love.
excellent.
I love to watch her because she just really gets into it.
Oh, that.
Actually, she has. It's another thing's important about her, I think, is because she does have Alzheimer's. And I
Oh,
have
wow.
to introduce myself every time that I go to train her. I have to remind her who I am.
Oh, my goodness.
But when
Wow.
we're exercising, she's focused on what we're doing. And I ask her to remember, I said, what do we do next in the sequence? What do we do next? And if she doesn't remember, I just kind of gently remind her. But she's getting to where she remembers more. And she asks me questions, and she's even asked me which muscle she's working when she's doing an exercise. And she's just more present when she's doing exercises, and her mind is just so much clearer. It's just really wonderful to be with her.
That's tremendous. What a testimonial. So, and we said earlier, your range of clientele that you specialize in training, is it over 60 years old? Is that correct?
Over 60.
Over
Over
60.
50, over 60. I usually, right now, everybody that I'm working with is over 60. So,
Excellent. And then all the way up to 92. Is there a limit to where you won't train in the maximum age
no, it
limit?
depends on what kind of shape they're in. I know.
Yeah.
I know. There's one woman that's still swimming at 101. She's still competing.
Oh wow, that's incredible.
There is somebody in the records. In the USA swimming records at 101.
That's amazing. Wow, gosh.
So there's no reason, I don't think there's any reason not to train unless you really have gotten to the point where you can't, so.
Yeah, no, that's wonderful. And so we mentioned this earlier too. You had talked about the importance of balance and strength training. Is that something as well that you focus on with your clients when you're training them?
Yes, I do. I focus on both balance and flexibility and strength.
Flexibility.
Yeah,
Yeah.
all of
Very, very
a
good.
lot of people feel like that older adults don't need strength training, but they really do.
You're
And they
right.
also need the balance. They need the balance and they need the flexibility. So I work with them to stretch. And I notice sometimes in my water aerobics classes that people will leave the pool when it's time to do the stretching, you know, and I always try to reel them back in and say, oh, come back and do the stretching. I know, you know, everybody's going to be lined up to get in the shower, but let's do the stretching because it's really important.
Yeah.
Actually, people over 60 should stretch for about 60 seconds rather than 30 seconds because it
Oh,
just
okay.
takes longer for their muscles and tendons to really get stretched out. So.
Sure. That makes a lot of sense. So the Family Life Center is where your training's been clients at. For folks who aren't familiar with that, that's in the heart of Buckhead right there on Peachtree Road. And how long have you been there now for?
Well, I've actually been there since last spring. I've been teaching water aerobics, and I still do that, but I recently just came on as a personal trainer. And it is
Okay.
such a fantastic facility for seniors. It's just with the pool and a huge walking track and lots of aerobic equipment. It's really very spacious, very comfortable, and there are a lot of older adults that go there, so it's a good social place too.
Oh, that's great. So if someone's watching and they want to try it out, and let's say they're intimidated to come in there because they are afraid of the whole stigmatism of big bodybuilders and muscle guys, and is that something they probably don't have to worry about when they come, let's say, to train with?
Absolutely.
Good.
Absolutely.
Okay, no, that's really, really good. Now, as far as. Oh, go ahead, I'm sorry.
It's really just folks, a lot of older folks and some younger folks, but it's really just people working out and being healthy. It's
That's
definitely not a bodybuilding gym.
sure, and I guess that goes to the name, it being Family Life Center, not Gold's Gym or Muscle Fitness or something like that. So that's good. Yeah. Now, let's talk. let's talk about what do you find most rewarding about working in this industry and what you're doing for other people? What is the like what does it come down to that you find just so rewarding about doing what you're doing?
Okay, that I feel like that when you get fit, I think a lot of people when they retire, they may not have any plans, they may not know exactly what it is they want to do. And they may feel like even if there's something that they think they might want to do, they may think maybe they can't. So I like to be the person that encourages them to go ahead and do that. And I think that fitness is the foundation. Fitness is the foundation that makes it possible for you to do that. If you're not strong and well balanced and have a lot of energy, then a big dream or a mission or something that you really want to do may not be possible. So I start with the fitness, but I always encourage people to go ahead and go for whatever else it is. And usually, once people start working out, they get more excited about what there is for them to do.
That's wonderful. And let me ask this too, because it sounds like you've got a really busy schedule. You work a lot, and just with day to day, and you're helping other people. Do you get a chance? When, how do you fit in your own workouts and your regimen of your own exercises?
Well, I have a trainer,
Good.
and I'm religious about going to my trainer, and that's just a very special time for me. He's also a mentor. He's a master trainer, and he's somebody that I can talk to about when I'm working with my clients. I can talk to him about that. And in fact, he even told me the other day that he wanted me to do a competition.
That's
And
wonderful.
so I just said, well, we'll think about that. It would be a year from now. So I'm beginning to think about it. But I usually try to pick up, I've got some weights at home, and when I go to the gym to train, I don't leave without doing whatever I need to do. So I make sure that I get it in. It's just really important to me. I also take a TRX class, which I have a lot of fun with. I love working on the TRX, and I use that with my clients. Even my older clients will use the TRX. So I just make sure that I get something in. I also swim. So usually after a water aerobics class, I'll swim 20 laps or so, just to keep it in. So I just kind of throw it in. I also have a stand-up desk, which is where when I'm writing or when I'm working on my computer, I'm standing up. If I'm sitting, I have a yoga ball, and so I'll stop in the middle of working and just just lean back and do about 10 sit-ups if I'm getting stiff. So I just try to work it in every time I can, because it's so important to me.
That's tremendous. It sounds like every year that's going by, it sounds like you're just getting in better and better shape year in and year out.
Yeah, that's the way it is. And
That's the way to do it. That's the way to live. What a testimony. And let's get your advice on we're entering right now the winter season. This is the lowest activity usage for gyms. People don't want to exercise because there's a bunch of excuses. It's too cold outside. We've been getting a lot of rain lately here in the Greater Atlanta area. Holidays, parties, going to Thanksgiving coming up here, and Christmas, and what kind of a suggestions or advice can you give the folks out there in terms of how to avoid those dreaded doldrums of avoiding all the putting on the pounds? Because a lot of people say, well, what would your advice be to that?
Oh, it's like go ahead and get started now
Yeah.
and head it off. And then make a commitment to really hit the ground running in January. But if you get started now, I've actually seen in the past 2 weeks, I've started two new clients. And there's no reason. I mean, I know it's almost Thanksgiving, but if you get started now, if you get the habit, get the routine, maybe you've got to take some time off while you're out of town. But when you come back, you've got something to come back to instead of starting something new in January. So what I'd say is, I'd say go for it now.
Love it. Even before we hit the new year, do it now. No time like the present.
Oh, yes.
Wonderful. That's a great note to summarize on there, Susan. I've really enjoyed this interview with you, and I hope that you'll take our invitation to come back on here for a follow-up in the very near future. Keep doing a great job. Let me get some information from you now so we can get it out to the folks. What's the best ways of contact method of how people are watching right now if they want to book a session with you, if they're interested in learning
Thank
more
you, Terrence.
information?
The best way is just to go to my website, which is www.susanlongley.com. and there is a communication form on the first page, so they can send me a note. I also have a blog they can subscribe to if they want to. And I've got some videos of some of my clients, and I've got some advice and some resources. So just kind of browse around there. You'll find out more about me, and you'll find this a way to communicate. So again, it's www.susanlongley.com.
Perfect. Okay. Excellent. And for anybody watching,
thanks.
We're going to
fade to black. Thanks for having me. Enjoy talking to you today.
Oh yeah. Likewise, Susan. Thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it. And I thoroughly enjoyed it. And we can't wait to have you back on here in the very near future here, very soon.
Thank you, Taryn.
Thank you, Susan. Keep doing what you're doing. And folks, thanks for watching. Here comes Susan's information right now. There was the website, everybody. I hope you took it down and bookmarked that as a favorite to your web browser and check her out today. That was Susan Longley from Family Life Center in Atlanta, Georgia. Susan, thank you so much. Wonderful interview there. Can't wait to have you back on, and keep doing what you're doing out there in Buckhead. And I commend you, and thank you for coming on today's show. Everybody else, thank you so much for watching. And again, I hope that everyone's having a nice Monday here. We've made it to Thanksgiving week. I can't believe that. Already, this month has just flown by, and we've had some really wonderful guests here on GoTaryn TV, and can't wait to see you on the next video blog. But in the meantime, until I do see y'all, a few other things I can ask of you after you are done checking out SusanLongley.com. Check out the website link right there at the bottom of your screen, www.gotaryn.tv. And you can also bookmark that as a favorite to your web browser and tell two people about the website today. Also, if you haven't done so, I urge you to please do the following three things. Like GoTaryn on Facebook, subscribe to GoTaryn on YouTube, follow GoTaryn on Twitter, and that way you will stay connected with this guy right here of GoTaryn Personal Training, Taryn the Traveling Trainer, always telling each and every one of you, it's your time, it's your investment, it's your life. Thanks for watching, folks. We'll see you later on the next video blog. And in the meantime, happy Thanksgiving, everybody.